you guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today, I wanted to do a very special video with a very special friend who's on high alert. Anytime that we're in my office and that the door is closed, he thinks that I'm trapping him in here because there is a delivery. I do an awful lot of online shopping, and there are a lot of deliveries that happen, and Carl does not love it. So he's on extra high alert. He's our tiny guard dog. So I figured I would take you guys through basically a life of Carl, a daily life of Carl. He has an interesting life and an interesting schedule. So you know how I do my morning routines? We're gonna take you through Carl's day routine. But first I'm gonna answer a couple of very common questions that I get about the little dude. So Carl is a hefty 7-pound Morky. he's little. He was supposed to be smaller. So a Morky is half Yorkie and half Maltese. So that's why he has a little bit of like Yorkie look, but he's fluffy AF. So he's actually getting groomed tomorrow. So it'll be really funny. If you guys want to see on Instagram the transformation, I'll take a picture of him before and a picture of him after. The difference is insane. It literally almost looks like he drops like a full 2 pounds. So he's getting groomed tomorrow and he's going to be adorable. So he has his own Instagram. Mama let him get an Instagram when he turned 2. So Carl is 3 going on 4, and Morkies live to be apparently like 16 years old. His vet said that he has a ton of Morkie customers and clienteles and patients that are pretty elderly. So Carl is, I have to say, tough as nails. He was up on, it's in his routine, he was up on the love sack this morning and jumped off of it, and I guess like he was scratching and missed a step and he fell off of it. And he's very durable. He's a tough little dude. The only thing is when we moved from our condo to our home, something almost like shifted in him that he no longer really trusted people that he didn't know from when he was a baby. So it's almost as though he feels attacked and he will go at people. So we usually, that's why if the doorbell rings or whatever, we'll put him outside. But I think it's more just an anxiety thing. And we've tried everything from an ultrasonic egg to help him stop barking. We've never tried a buzz collar, and I don't want to do that because he's so small. We've tried like the pheromone collar that like helps him with the smells to calm him down. Nothing has really worked. We've tried the little jackets, but he's okay. We just got to learn to manage it. So we have little tricks that, you know, help him. But We think that the best thing is to just keep him on his leash whenever we know that guests are coming, and then that way he knows when he's on his harness that he doesn't have to protect us. So other than that little anxiety bit, he's a very, very easy dog. He's not an outdoor dog at all. He loves to walk, but only if the weather is perfect. So if it's too hot or too cold, he does not want to go outside, hence the fact that he goes to the washroom inside too. He basically has like a little pee pad. The same as if you were training a dog, that's what he uses because he doesn't go outside. Until this winter, how he discovered that he likes to go outside, and he goes on our balconies now, but at least they're covered in snow, so it's fine. But I actually got this little turf pee pad for outside as well, so he goes on that. Hopefully we can kind of curve it so that he doesn't wreck our balconies. But that is, I guess, the life of Carl. We got him in Brampton, Ontario, in Canada, so we drove about 5 hours. That was actually the first ever YouTube video that I posted. If you guys want to go see it, it's hilarious. Andre and I look way younger, and really, like, the video is filmed on my iPhone, like, vertically. It's hilarious. But Carl, as a baby, if it's possible, like, he was cuter. Like, he's so cute as a baby. He was like this big with like a big tail. And he was super fluffy in his little tail. Like when he met, I can't watch the video because it makes me cry. When our moment that we first met was on there. So we went to pick him up, drove him home. He was a handful from the get-go. Like we were super overwhelmed by what we had gotten ourselves into, but he's honestly the love of our life. Like he's like our kid. So his name is Carl Bellemare. That's what he goes as on Instagram. That's his Instagram handle. And he's named after Carl Fredrickson from Up. We were going to get an Ellie, but then we got Carl, and that was plenty. So that's the story of little Carl. What else is there about? What else do you want to share about yourself? We shared your weight, the fact that you love food. He has trigger words like salmon and grandma and treats. He loves food. It's his favorite thing. So he, like I said, he's a pretty simple dog. Like he doesn't really go outside. He doesn't love to walk. He gets his daily exercise from just playing around the house with us. He's very independent. Like he will grab his toys and play by himself. Other than the random barking, if there is a postal service person, he's super lovable, super cuddly. He sleeps at the edge of our bed with us. Yes, he is spoiled AF. but we love him, and he's a good little dude, a little fluffy fellow. So from that, we will take you guys into Carl's day routine, and I hope you guys enjoy it. It's something that was hugely requested. And if you guys have any questions about Carl, or if you guys do want to follow him on Instagram, or if you guys have suggestions or whatever, by all means, comment down below and give this video a thumbs up if you guys liked it. Don't forget to subscribe because we've got daily videos coming in. Bye, dudes.
One more time.